Good evening, students. I am Mrs. Parvati, PGT Physics, Holy Hearts Educational Academy, Raipur, Chhattisgarh. Today, I would like to discuss a very, very important question for your board examination, that is Gauss Theorem. What is Gauss Theorem and how can you prove it? That we are going to discuss now. Right? Before we state the Gauss Theorem, we should know, in the previous class, we discussed what is electric flux. How do you calculate flux for different general closed surfaces or any closed surface or for symmetrical surface like that. So electric flux is nothing but the field lines passing through a given surface or crossing through a given surface of area perpendicular to the surface is called electric flux. You know the formula, phi E is equal to integral closed surface E dot ds or E ds cos theta, right? The Gauss theorem said Gauss is a mathematician. He has given the relation between electric field intensity and the charge contained by that closed surface. Once again I repeat, Gauss theorem gives relation between the charge contained by the closed surface and the electric flux. It states that, Gauss theorem states that the total flux linked with the closed surface kept in an electric field is 1 by epsilon naught times the charge enclosed inside the surface when the object, when the surface is kept in air or free space. Once again, I define or I state the Gauss law as like this. The total flux linked with the closed surface when it is kept in air or free space and kept in electric field is equal to 1 by epsilon naught times the charge enclosed inside the surface. For example, if this is the surface of the closed surface, the charge present is inside 6 positive and outside also there are 4. But we consider only, the Gauss theorem is applicable only inside the charge. Outside the charge, there is no effect. The flux will not be affected for the outside charge, only for inside the charge. And suppose, another example, outside the surface, you take the surface, then outside only the charge is present, inside the charge is zero. So, then flux passing through the inside the surface is zero here. When charge is zero, then flux is zero. When charge is there, then flux is present. It's clear? Okay. Now, so what is the mathematical form of Gauss theorem? Integral E dot ds is equal to phi E is equal to Q by epsilon naught, where epsilon naught is the electrical permittivity of air or free space. That means you have to keep the charge or surface only in air or free space, then only this law holds good. If it is kept in medium, then you know how to do it. Then K, where K is the electric constant of the medium, then the formula will become Q by K epsilon naught, where K is the dielectric constant of the medium that we are not discussing at present. When the surface is kept in medium, we are not discussing now, right? Okay. So, how do you prove it, this Gauss law? It's very important question for the board point of view also. Proof. To prove that, consider a spherical surface and give some charge on the surface. The charge is here, plus Q charge is there on the surface at the center. You know that electric field lines due to this charge is perpendicular, outward drawn, normals drawn outward. This is the direction of electrical field. See the arrow mark? Outward. Because it is positive charge. You know the meaning of E. When you bring the plus one charge here, there is a force of repulsion. So, they are moving away. The electric field lines are moving outward here. It's clear? Okay. Let us take the radius of the sphere is R. Consider a small area here, ds. You know ds is the area means perpendicular to the ds area is normal, unit vector, you know that. And also the electric field also in the same direction. So the angle between electric field and the normal drawn to the surface is theta, that is 0. So cos 0 is 1. Right? So let us take this left hand side of Gauss law. integral E dot ds is equal to integral E ds cos theta. What is theta? Just now I explained, theta is 0. So, the value is E ds. E is constant. This Gauss law is applicable for uniform electric field. So, E at every point it is constant. So, that is why E you take outside. Then integral ds you take. Integral ds, what is the surface area of the spherical surface? It is 4 pi r square. Substitute the value here, integral ds value. 4 pi r square, 4 pi r square gets cancelled. So, what is left here? Q by epsilon naught, which is equal to RHS. In this way, we can prove the Gauss theorem for a spherical surface, not only spherical surface, for any general closed surface also you can prove it. If you are interested, please go through the textbook. Right? So, now I would like to ask you a conceptual question, very important, and how much you have understood the concept of Gauss law. The question is Gauss theorem possible for a dipole? Here I have taken a single charge and we have calculated, right? If I take dipole, two equal and opposite charges, can we apply Gauss theorem over there? The answer is no, not at all. Why? The reason is because in Gauss theorem, proof depends on Coulomb's law, that is inverse square law. In Gauss theorem proof, we are using inverse square law, Coulomb's law of electrostatics. Right? But whereas in dipole, if we have already done, the electric field due to dipole is inversely proportional to R cube. So, it is not square, inverse square law. It is not obeying inverse square law, dipole. So, that is the reason we cannot apply Gauss law for dipole. Once again, I repeat, Gauss law cannot be applicable for dipole. Because dipole electric field intensity is following cubic law, that is inversely proportional to 1 by r cube, whereas the Gauss law follows Coulomb's law, it is inverse square law, inversely proportional to 1 by r square. So, this question you have to remind children, it may be asked in the board examination. Thank you. Bye-bye.